wonder of our way. I'm so blessed that God provides for me in every single way. I'm so blessed that God grants me mercy each and every day. So blessed, yes, I am so blessed.
In every way. Oh, Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though ye were dead, ye shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. And I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, write, blessed are the dead which die in the Lord from henceforth. Yea, saith the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors, and their works do follow them. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself. And where I am, there you may be also. And whither I go, ye know the way. Ye know. Thomas said unto him, Lord, we know not whither thou goest, and how can we know the way? Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Blessed good evening to you again. We welcome you to this Thanksgiving service for Virginia Evadne Clarke. Let us pray. Father, we just want to thank you. In midst, Lord God, of life, there's death. And God, it seems that we never get used to saying so long to loved ones. But Father, we are thankful, God, that you're in the midst of us, God, and you're always with us. And your word comfort us, God, that they that die in Christ, Father, once we live Christ, once we come to that relationship, we will see them again. Father, we thank you for the life of Evadne. Father, a woman that stood for God, a woman that stood in faith, even to the end, God, a woman that lived the life, Father, of knowing you as Lord and Savior. So, Father, we don't have to pray for her because we know absent from the body is present with you. So we know that she's with you, God. But I pray, God, for her family. Lord, her children, God. Father, Lord God, the grandchildren. Lord, family members. Lord, even us, Father, her family. God, I ask that your supernatural strength will undergird us even at this time, God. And Father, you will surround us with your peace. Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus that we would live, Lord God, out a life, Father, that we too will see Evadne again, God. Father, we ask that your peace will be present as we talk well and speak well about her today. And again, we ask that you would just minister, Lord God, in this place, and some heart and life will come to the saving knowledge of Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. At this time, we're going to ask our worship leader to come and just lead us in a couple songs. So remain standing. And then after that, you may take your seats. God bless you.
Good afternoon. And please join with me in singing the first song on your hymn sheets, Goodness of God.
I love you, Lord. Oh, your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hand. From the moment that I wake up till I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of God.
Chorus, all my life.
And all my life you have been faithful. All of my life, all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am
of the goodness of God. I love your voice. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire in darkest nights. You are close like no other. I've known you as a father. I've known you as a friend. And I have lived in the goodness of God all my life. All my life you have been faithful. All my life, all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. Goodness keeps running. Your goodness is running after, is running after me. Your goodness is running after, is running after me. With my life laid down, I surrender now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after, is running after me. Your goodness is running. Your goodness is running after, is running after me. Your goodness is running after, is running after me. With my life laid down, I surrender now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after, is running after me. All my life, all my life you have been faithful. All of my life, all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. Sing that chorus one last time. All my life, all my life you have been faithful. Ooh, all my life you have been so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. I will sing of the goodness of God. God, we thank you for your faithfulness and your goodness. The next song we're going to sing right after this one is Believe For It. It is the second song on your hymn sheet. For we know that hope is never lost. They say this mountain can be moved. They say these chains will never break. But they don't know you like we do. There is power in your name. We've heard that there's no way through. We've heard the tide will never change. They haven't seen what you can do. There is power. Power in your name. hope is never lost. We know that hope is never lost. For there is still an empty grave. God, we believe no matter what, there is power in your name.
I knew about Evadne, and I called her Evadne affectionately, is that she believed and she trusts God. At this time, we are going to have our first scripture reading from Proverbs 31, and we invite Marlo St. Hill to come, and if her sisters can come and support her, that's fine. I know that this is not an easy time for them, and right after the scripture reading, we will have a tribute by Patricia Torp, and Patricia was her care group leader, one of her care group leaders.
Good afternoon, all. The Bible's lesson is taken from Proverbs 31, verse 10, verses 14 to 16, 25 to 31. Who can find a virtuous woman? She's far more precious than jewels. She's like a merchant ship bringing her food from far away. She rises while it is still night and provides for her household. She evaluates a field and she buys it. She plants a vineyard with her earnings. Strength and honor are her clothing. And she can laugh at the time to come. She opens her mouth with wisdom and loving instruction is in her mouth and on her tongue. She watches over the activities of her household and is never idle. Her daughters and sons rise up and call her blessed. Many women are capable. But with you, you surpass them all. Charm is deceptive and beauty is fleeting. But a woman who fears the Lord will be praised. Give her the reward of her labor and let her works praise her at the city gates. Here ends the Bible reading.
Good afternoon, everyone. I know this is a very sad time, and so just in case I don't say that, remember to say this before I finish. I want to just offer my deepest condolences to the family on the behalf of my husband, Paul, and the Newton Care Group. We loved Evadne very much. I have known Evadne, or Clarke, as she used to call herself, for over 6 years. She was a faithful member of our care group. Evadne had many qualities, but cooking and giving are two that comes to my mind. Cooking. At our care group meetings, Evadne would always bring some delicious meal to the refreshment table to share with everyone. Cucumber and tuna sandwiches, fish cakes, barbecue wings, sweet bread. And Daniel told me she liked her corned beef sandwiches especially. But my favorite was her sweet potato pudding. That was the best. Evadne was a giver. And whenever you passed her home, she always has something to give you from her garden, whether it's green bananas, pumpkin, passion fruit, green peas, and so on. And she would always tell you how she was giving the neighbor this, and she just gives somebody something else. She was always giving. She never was one that would, you know, hold on to everything. Clarke was a giver. If you saw a plant in her garden that you admired, she would break off a piece and she would tell you how to plant it. She raised chickens, and she also raised some good tasting chickens. And when she killed them, she would always believe in the first fruits, in that she would bless Apostle Stephen and Apostle Sandra, and she would also bless my family as well. And anyone else, you know, she would just bless them with. Any donations needed for any good causes, whether at church or any other person going through any difficulties, Evadne was always willing to offer and to share anything or donate anything to them. Last year at the nursing home where I worked, my cook was sick and I didn't know what to do. And Evadne said, "Patty, bring the ingredients. I'll do the cooking." And she did. She didn't ask for anything. She was able to give in of her time. As long as I knew Evadne, I would say that she had a strong faith. And I really appreciate that song that Shauna chose, Believe For It, because she really had a strong belief for a lot of things that she was asking God for. And whenever life's challenges came to her, she would come by my home or call me and we would pray. And then we'd patiently wait and see God's hand unfold. I remember the night when her grandson Kyle got into an accident. Evadne called me and we prayed. And by faith, we saw God's hand heal Kyle, and he's now out of intensive care and he's walking today. Evadne would always be praying for her family, her children, her grandchildren. She loved them and she always wanted the best for them. Evadne had a warm spirit, but she also had an effervescent laugh. And this would come up from her belly and it became very infectious when you were around her. When we were at care group and Mrs. Skeet and Lemuel cracked some jokes, that was it. Care group was finished. Evadne was laughing and all of us was catching on for the rest of the night. The last night we had a prayer meeting a couple of weeks ago, there was Evadne amongst us praying and believing in God and encouraging us, Lorna, Sherianne, Charlene and myself. She was encouraging us to keep trusting God, that God is good and her God is good. And on the 5th of December, when I went to visit Evadne, she was in bed. I got there and I sat on the floor and held her hand and we prayed. She believed and had faith and she said, Patty, God got me. She told me she wasn't feeling well the night in front, but she felt better that day. And I told her, we were talking about how the care group was looking forward to coming to visit her. And then Marlo and Sam came in and we sat on the bed and we were talking. I felt like one of her daughters because they were just joking and talking about some, I won't get into it, it was personal stuff. I mean, Sam and Marlo might not want me to talk their business out. See, look, Sam, they're laughing, yeah. I didn't know that was the last time I would see Evadne, but I'm glad for that being such a treasured memory because I remember seeing her laughing and she did a lot of that. Evadne, girl, Clarke, I'm going to miss you. But I know that you are with God. Like you said, God got you, and you are with God. And one day, I hope to pray, I will see you too. So be blessed, and may she rest in peace. Thank you.
At this time, we'll have the second scripture reading from Proverbs 3, 5 to 6. And this is Delia Catlin. She's going to come. And then right after, tribute by Debbie Lawrence.
Church, good evening, each and everyone. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and do not rely on your own understanding. Think about Him in all your ways, and He will guide you on your right path. Do not consider yourself to be wise. Fear the Lord and turn away from evil, for this will be healing for your body and strengthening. Here ends the Bible reading.
Good evening to all. I am Debbie Lawrence, and I would like to start by, well, first I called her, somebody called her Evadne. I've never heard the name Evadne, but I called her Virgie. Now, in this day when everything around us, this is particularly since the COVID, it seems so tumultuous. Everything is a lot. It seems like something has started back and we don't have the energy for it. or that there's hardly any energy and you're kind of getting back into it all. I think that I've found that we need people around us, good, simple, sweet people. And for me, Virgie was that person. Now, I have not, this is strange, but I have not known Virgie for a very long time. It's just about 2 years. And we met under very strange circumstances. Now, I'm from a village, but we move on a little bit, and I have gone somewhere else to live where I bought some property. And Virgie's daughter happened to have a piece of land next to me. There's not a house there. But as we know, you know how it goes, you know? When there are some people, certainly not me, but we move there and we think only whackers can cut grass and all these fancy people come with trucks. So during the COVID, the land was overgrown somewhat. And then one morning I was at work and my daughter called and said, "Mommy, there's a lady out here and she has a hoe. She is working on this land." And I said, "Who is she? Go and ask her." So my daughter went, she came back to me and I said to her, "Ask her to give me a call or leave a number." So she left a number and I called her the afternoon and I told her, well, we were all going to put together and clean all the lots that didn't have houses on them, you know, to everybody in the community, that is. So we did that and Virgie came, she gave her contribution and so on. 2 months after all this bush and everything came back, Virgie decided, I said, well, we are doing it again. She said, okay, don't include me though, I come in. Virgie turned up with her hoe, her shovel, and some other paraphernalia. And let me tell you, Virginia started to one corner. And let me tell you that the lot is bigger than this building. She started to one corner. And she worked her way up. Every morning at 6 o'clock, she would turn up. And she would shout me, and I would say, you can't call names, but, you know, there was one person who was very much against it, you know. You know, why is this person coming and doing this and working? Like, please. So, Virgie came, 6 o'clock every morning, and she worked that land. She started at one corner, and she went to the other corner. Then she went from the east, and she went right back to the other corner. And I would look out the window like a good old village girl and shout, "Virginia!" And she would shout back, "Hi, Debbie!" And we could see some people looking out like, why are these people like behaving like this? We know where we're from, you know? And I would say, "How are you today?" And she would say, "I good, how are you? You good?" "Yes." And I would watch for the sun, and when I was leaving around 8:30 or 9, I would demand and command that she left there while I was gone, because I didn't want the sun to come up and something happen and I come back and find her there or whatever. And she would obey. She would obey. She would come out and so on. And then one morning I passed and I said, "You need to plant some stuff, you know." And she said, "But you don't think people..." I said, no, that's your land. You do what you want." And Virginia planted some pumpkin. Then Virginia planted cassava. Then she planted bananas. And then another morning I came out and I said, this was, I think it might have been in March. And I said, "Virgie, you got to plant some green peas, you know, so we'll get green peas at Christmas time." And she planted green peas. Now, I was invited a few days ago by her daughters to come and get some of the green peas, because if you were to see beautiful, everything she touched, she planted watermelons. And those watermelons were the best, huge, sweet watermelons she planted. Virginia was giving everybody, those who complained and those who didn't, pumpkins. She put all the pumpkins to the side of the street and of the road, and everybody came. I would mention Dwayne Smith, the former cricketer, or the cricketer. When I told, one day Dwayne didn't see her. We didn't see her for like 3 days. And he passed by and he tooted and he said, "Debbie, I don't see the lady who comes here." I said, "You know the lady who comes here?" He said, "Of course, she's my friend." I said, "But how she get your friend?" He said, "But she's giving me pumpkins and she don't give you none." I said, "That's not true. I get everything that come out that ground and I get it first." So Virginia, for me, Virgie was Those are the circumstances under which we met. Virginia became a friend. Virginia became in my garage. I left stuff there. If she wanted anything, I always had a chair there that she could. And I told her, if you get tired, you want to sit down. Sometimes she would bring her grandson. And we meshed in that friendship. It feels like I've known Virginia for 20 years. It doesn't feel like just 2 years. Virginia was, she was the closest person to me that I have met. That was my, like my mother. Virginia, she talked about her. I met her daughters over and over. Her son, I haven't met the son, but I met her family over and over before I actually met them. Virginia would give her all her life. She worked that land because her daughter could not get here because she was had someone else to do it. They weren't doing a good job, and Virginia came and she took on the task. That is a mother's love. Virginia loved her children. The way she embraced me, then it would tell you how she loved her children. And she would always say, Debbie, I got beautiful children, you know. So when I met the children, I haven't met the sons, but when I met the children, they are really, really beautiful. And not just because of their outer appearance, but I'll tell you, they have so much of their mother. There is a sweetness, and that's how I always describe Virginia. My children would laugh at Virginia and I on mornings when we greeted each other through the window, and I was shouting that we were having this conversation and all that. But that was fine, because now she's gone. I am so happy we had those conversations. We talked about things and so on. I gave her Mother's Day gift, and I was thinking, I don't know if she would really want it. And you know, I'll tell you something, and I want to share this with you. The things in life you want to do, do them. The people you want to say, I love you, tell them. Because I always remember when Virginia told me she was ill. And I thought to myself, what if I didn't give her the Mother's Day gift? And it was just after Mother's Day. I wanted to give it to her on Mother's Day. And I did. And I was still, No. Let us not live our lives like that. Let us live our lives like, you know, we say, you're good, no, there ain't no tomorrow. And people take it casually. These days, there really ain't no tomorrow. We don't have it. Because Virginia passed on the Friday night. And I took holiday on that Friday. I had a conversation with Virginia the week prior. And I said to her, she called me. And I said, Virgie, I am down to it. And she understood what I meant when I said I was down to it. Work just had me. I said, but I am on holiday from next Friday. And you know, she said, yeah, and we're going to sit and we're going to talk. And she said, don't forget the bacon. So I was supposed to take that bacon on the Friday. A friend of mine, who his mother is ill, and she passed this morning. And I was rushing to get to the airport to give him a card to give to his mother. And I thought, let me go at the same time. I didn't, because I was rushing to get to the airport, then one thing after the next. I did not get to see Virginia. I didn't get to see her. But you know, the funny thing is, I didn't get to see her. But the thing is, I know that she wouldn't hold that against me. She wouldn't. So I just want to say, he who sows courtesy reaps friendship. And he who plants kindness gathers love. May she rest in peace. Thank you.
When you meet somebody like Evadne, you would talk all day. But our time is running really, really quickly. So at this time, we're going to have the eulogy read by her daughters. So I want them to come. And right after that, there will be a tribute and so.
Hello, good evening, church.
Good evening, church.
We're Clarke's daughters. We'll start from the back because my sister's shy. I'm Sam and I'm the youngest. Marlo is next, Nindelia, and Pets. Our mom was born on February the 3rd, 1953, which made her 71. And she was lovely. I just want to share one thing that really resonates with my mom, apart from how much she loved us, was her discipline and her strictness. This woman, when I was younger, we can go anywhere. You say, Mom, we can go to the, where you going? Where is you want to go? Stay home. And this one, but you know what? Now that we're grown, we can see how she protected us. And we're really happy for that. Thank you, Mom. And she left her cooking gene for me. I can cook real good. Honestly, I cook the best. I just wanted to say that. Because, like, I get that whole gene. Okay, for me, what I'm going to miss most about Mom is her cooking. She would always say, Petty, on your way home, stop for this parcel. It used to be sweet bread, maybe cake, maybe chicken, ham, and don't forget to give Marlo some and Delia. So Mom, we were going to really miss that, those goodies from you.
Good evening again. Both my sisters said something that I wanted to say. Yes, Mom, she did a very good job. She taught me well. She gave me tough love. When I tell you tough love, too much tough love. That I'm still here standing, and I want to say, I will miss you, Mom. And I thank you. Yes, I got the more slicks, by the way. Thank you, Marlo. Stop that. But it was tough love. And one day I said to Mom, I said, Mom, you know something? I really thank you, you know, Mom. I thank you so much, you don't even know. She said, for what, Delia? I said, Mom, the tough love you put on me. And this woman started to laugh. I mean laugh. She said, I had to do it to you. I had to do it, Delia. But I thank you, Mom. You did a good job on me and my sisters. Thank you, Mom. I will miss you. Thank you.
Excuse me. Thank you. So we had to plan the funeral in a week. And they say write a eulogy. So these are the two blank papers, because what you write about your mommy that isn't already known? And how do you stop yourself from shaking, like waking up literally vibrating in the bed and don't know how you're going to get through it? But the grace of God is sufficient, because God brought us up with a mother that knew God and she loved the Lord, and everyone here can testify to that. She would always bless those with whom she came into contact with. And if you think it wasn't bad enough, Romario, you can stand. Just stand a bit. When Mary lost his daddy at age 5, mommy was mommy, granny, daddy for all of us, for the two of us. Our household was made up of two persons left back. Mary and I, it was mommy, granny, daddy, or mommy, daddy, or granny, daddy. And Mom raised my son with me. She was a beautiful soul. We know that as nurses, I just want to say thank you to all of you who are here. Because, you know, you've shown us an outpouring of love. And with that, it meant that there were shifts to work. And my boss should be somewhere here. I'm not seeing you, but good evening, my boss is. And he can attest that I have less than 5 days sick leave for nearly 30 years when I work at the hospital. It meant that I had to have a support system. And that support system meant that raising a child without a father meant you had to have a really strong mommy who stepped up to the plate. And that is exactly what mommy did for all of us. She greased down Romario with every olive oil she put her hand on. He would wake up greasy in the morning. She greased down Marley and Jolie and Finley. Whenever she put her hand on the children, she would bless them, you know. she would bless the earth. She would bless everything and everyone she came in contact with. She would say, "Hear, O earth, and be blessed." As she sowed the seeds, as Debbie spoke about, she would reap bountiful harvest. And as you know, we chose that Proverbs 31, a truly, truly virtuous woman. And as we come to her new name is Virginia, I think that's the virgin that resonated out of Evadne. Many persons here would know Mommy as Evadne, and those on the stream, many persons could not be here today, but Mommy was known as Evadne for about 64 years of her 71 years of life. And God has been so gracious to us. He gave us a new family when Mommy turned 64. Yvette and Verona, I just want you to stand. These are my other two aunties, and there are seven more. We had a new family born at age 64. If you all were there on that Christmas day when we celebrated together, there was a whole circle of tears of joy, because when all the old people went to their grave, nobody had the gall to say, "This was your dad." But Mommy's was there, and she never moved from where she was. And these two aunties evolved because they were persistent, and they kept saying, "Well, who is Evadne? Well, who is Evadne?" But she's here today to let us know that we have a brand new family, and all of you all have become part of our family because the grace of God and how she touched each and every one of your lives. That's the Mommy we knew. Yes? Grand Malteser. When Mommy went through her illness, she had, I'm seeing some of my oncology team here. I just want to say thank you. God bless you for doing a beautiful job with Mommy. Mommy's illness was so short and quick. Everything was like a whirlwind happening. But all of my bosses and my staff and my members at the hospital and my sisters, we never let go of each other. My brothers, we were all there for each other, and we held Mommy strong. Mommy went to her grave knowing that we were loved and she was truly loved. I asked God to help me never to leave Mom alone. And I asked him, when she dies, I want her to die on my arms. And Mommy died right here. She died in Romario's arms when we were taking her back to a comfort zone. You know, despite her distress, she never left us to be struggling with health care because our family is pretty small. Mommy was there to the end. Talk about her skills. Whew. Mommy could do chenille dolls, Girls Industrial Union, every course that was offered at the Girls Industrial Union. Mommy put her hand to the plow. She did her chenille dolls. She did her crochets. She made dresses for us. If you see the little girls in the little plaid dresses, because we were not very fortunate when we started out in life. We were rather humble. We came from rather humble beginnings, but she taught us discipline. She taught us love. And Daddy reinforced, if you have a biscuit, share it in four. Thank God for my beautiful sisters. They've never left me down. Despite all of us have our shortcomings, I know I have my shortcomings. But you know what? Mommy was there to support us. She never left us alone. We would go on and do Bible studies with Mom. We met her prayer groups. Yeah? She took us to the stations of the cross. Every church Mom went to, she would say, "Come, Marlo, I'm coming for you." I remember living in the nurse's home. And you know, you're isolated, you just have your friends. But Mommy would come down, and we would go across to the Roman Catholic Church, and we would kneel at the stations of the cross. That stands out in my head. Just remembering Mom there going down gracefully and bowing down to serve the true and living God that she worshiped, and she knew he was so good. And he always said, "My blessings gonna flow after me, and they're gonna flow onto you all." And I tell you, they have not stopped up to this day. We are still receiving the blessings of God. Yes? Let me just finish up. I can't see no more. Dilemma. Let me give you one joke. So it was graduation time, 1991, and mommy was, I hope there are no policemen in the crowd. You can do by the show of hands. Okay, we should be safe to say then. Because mommy drive for 10 years. 10 years without a license.
Well done, mommy.
When it was time to get to the law school, mommy picked me up in the car, and I was chief cook and bottle washer for the graduation. She made all the food, she made all the cakes, she up and down, and mom didn't have any, she was careful, mind you, never had an accident. Give her a round of applause for that. Mommy never had an accident. She drove for 10 straight years without that license. She was resilient. Mommy was tough and beautiful. And you know, it's hard at Christmas time for my sisters and I to really say bye-bye to mommy, because I just want you all to continue to remember us in prayer, because it's hard when even looking at a picture, you see I have a cruise line here and mommy's smiling back at you. Mommy was set to sail very shortly. But that didn't happen. But if you look and see what's happening, this is one that came off her cruise line. Right there. So she loved to travel. Mommy loved to shop. And when it is time for the boat to pull up anchor and move off, the others would say, look, I'm going to get on this boat before Marlo met the ship left me. And mom would never leave Marlo. Pet would always resonate and say, mom used to say, but Marlo, Marlo, because she know Marlo coming, and she would never leave me. In the land shop in Dominica, she waited, you know. It was so lovely to have her, all of her in-laws she embraced, and they all became the new family. Mommy traveled far and wide. She went to Prague, the Czech Republic. She was planning to go to Spain. She went to the Bahamas, she went to Paris, and the day when she was in Paris, she didn't have a very good experience, because she almost got one daughter left behind, and she was at the window of the train, and the other sister was at the window of the train, and none of them can't speak French. But the train was moving, and one of the daughters got left in Paris. But we were sensible enough to know, if you go that far up, we're gonna stay and wait for you just where you left us, and you're gonna come right back and meet us. So mommy didn't leave, she stayed right there as instructed, and true to form, that particular daughter came right back down in Paris, and she never got lost. There are three of them behind there. I'm not calling any names. I'm not calling any names, but one got left behind. And I just want to say, every time she moved off the machine, I learned to stitch, because when she got up to stitch, to cut, I run on the machine. When it was black cake time, she said, Marlo, off, she's heading off to work. She said, Mar, stick the knife in the cake, and when it comes out dry, take out the cake. And all of those things mommy taught us. Yeah, she taught us a lot of skills, and you know, she was really, really blessed as a mommy. And I just want to say thank you. And I know that all of you here have been touched in a special way by her life. She loved Auntie Undine. And then Auntie Undine, just that same day mommy died, she was coming, Auntie. Just be reassured she was coming. But her body was too weak. And the last thing she told us, literally Thursday night, she said she wouldn't come out of the bed. She was there breathing shallowly. And she said, we begged her to come and sit in the recliner chair. And she said, you know what? Let me get, she pushed up her mouth, and she was good at strips into. And she said, let me go and sit down in this chair before when I break, when I heart in here tonight. And I will tell you, she died that night, but she went through the day. She woke up in the morning, and she woke up in the morning. We took her to the hospital, and she came back home. But she waited for everyone. She waited for Sam running back out to England. But she waited. She had a surprise visit from Sam. And she gave us perfect timing, just enough to compose ourselves before the holiday season and catch our breath and kiss her a beautiful goodbye, because we know that she is in heaven. If you know the woman that was our mommy, she is truly in heaven because she's an angel. And I know she's singing right now with the heavenly host. And she's telling me to let you all know, continue to love the Lord and serve him. Yes? I just want to say thank you. And she's going to encourage everyone to trust God and let him lead the way. She promised your latter will be greater. Remember that. Yeah? And she said the blood of Jesus. I just want my blood again be good. And good she is today, because she's in a good place. As we lay her down to sleep, mommy, we know that we will never hug and touch you, but you've left us with our family, our brothers and our sisters, and your grandchildren, all the ones in England, Tony and Sam and Marley and Jolie, we love you. Finley, and all of our friends who couldn't come from UK, from Japan, from all over the world. We know that you're seeing the live stream, and we just want to thank you for being there to support us in every possible way, and all who are here. Thank you. May God bless you and keep you sweet. Have a beautiful Christmas. And remember us as we go through our mourning. We thank God for you. Thank you for every service you have offered. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you.
If you get around this family, especially Marlo. Marlo will now begin to preach, so you just have the sermon, right?
Just get down, right?
God bless you. God will give you strength. God will give you strength. At this time, we'll have a tribute in song. And then closing remarks. Is Vicky Busher here? Marla, was she, the singer didn't come? She's not well? Okay. So we're going to invite Evangelist to just closing remarks.
Amen. Just very briefly, I want to encourage you in the word, and I'm going to be very fast today, but I want to encourage you, like the songwriter said when he declared and asked a question, will your anchor hold in the storms of life when the clouds unfold their wings of strife? When the strong tides lift and the cable strain, will your anchor drift or firm remain? We have an anchor that keeps the soul steadfast and sure while the billows roll. Fastened to the rock which cannot move, grounded firm and deep in the Savior's love. I use this song today because I believe that all that we have heard, all that we have experienced today as we celebrate and remember the life of Virginia Evadne Clarke, is because she had her anchors that held her, and her anchor was Jesus Christ. And today, as you've heard about her life and her love for God, I want to really encourage you to choose Jesus Christ just as she chose Jesus Christ. It is clear, it is evident, it is before us that she lived a life that was full, a life that was abundant, and I would say abundant in Christ. And even this afternoon, as we have come to commemorate and to remember her, I want to encourage you also to remember Jesus Christ. He is the one who made a difference in Virginia Evadne Clarke's life. I'm sure she had many experiences. I'm sure there's living that she did, but there is one that she would credit everything to, and that is God. And we've heard that today. And I want to ask you today the simple question, what is the anchor that is holding your life together? Because the reality is that there could be so many things in this world, but they will all fade away according to the word of God. The only thing that remains and remains steadfast is the word of God. In John 14:6, Jesus declared, "I am the way, the truth, and the life." And when we look into the word of God, we see clearly, as he was telling the disciples about his departure, that this was one of the anchors that he was encouraging them to hold on to. The anchor of choosing him as the only way. So today, what is your anchor? What is that which you hold on to? And as we close our eyes and we begin to go into a moment of reflection, I want you to think about your life and to think about what is before you. Yes, the time that has passed, but also the days that lie ahead. And ask yourself the question, is my life truly anchored in such a way that I will receive the promise that Jesus left in John 14 when he said, "I am leaving here to go and prepare a place for you so that I may come back again and receive you to myself." As you think through your life, the days that lie ahead of you, can you say honestly within your heart today that you are anchored in Christ, that you will be one that is received by Jesus? And if today you can say, "Well, I really don't have that hope, I don't have that assurance," I want to offer you Jesus Christ today. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him will not perish, but have everlasting life. And today I encourage you, just as Virginia Evadne Clarke chose Christ, you today choose Christ as well, so that you can live that truly abundant life in him. And if today, as our eyes are closed and our heads are bowed, and you want to say yes to Jesus, just raise your hand right where you are so that you can have that assurance, that certainty, and we'll pray with you just before we close the service. Is there anyone today? Raise your hand, put it back down. We're not going to ask you to come forward. Thank you, sir. Maybe there's another one. Thank you, ma'am. Maybe another today who is saying, "Yes, I want to have that anchor in Jesus Christ, knowing that my life is secure in him." And for this young man and this daughter and this lady that said, "Yes, I want to choose Christ," and any others today, whether you're seated here or on the stream, you can say this prayer after me with hope in your heart, believing that God does hear you. Heavenly Father, I thank you today for Jesus Christ. I thank you that you sent him into this world to die for my sins and to cleanse me from all unrighteousness. I now give my life over to him, and I thank you for teaching me, leading me, and guiding me in all truth. In Jesus' name, amen and amen and amen. And if today you've made a decision to serve Jesus Christ, to choose him, to be certain that your life is anchored, we encourage you to find a Bible-believing church that you can connect with to grow in your walk with the Lord. At this time, we just want to bless the family and pray for them, and we ask the family to stand just as we prepare to head over to lay this body to rest. We bless you today, and we pray that God would keep you, uphold you with his mighty hand. The Bible declares God is a God of comfort. And Father, we thank you today for these family members. Lord, even as they go through this time of transition, this time of change, knowing that mom is not here, auntie, sister, Lord, I pray that you will continue to keep them and uphold them with your mighty hand. Thank you for being the God of all comfort, as your word declares, in their lives. And may the sweet memories of this loved one live on in their hearts forever and ever. Father, I pray today that they would understand that they can rely on you and trust in you during this very difficult time to keep them and to preserve them. So, Father, we declare comfort and peace and hope upon the family members today. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. God bless you.
Amen. I just want us to stand as we sing our final hymn, but I just want to extend condolences on behalf of Apostle Stephen, myself, the eldership, the leaders, the members of this church. We want to let you know that we will be praying for you. Evadne was a beautiful woman, and I feel like I'm one of her daughters. As Pat said, there's never a time that she would not be sending something to bless us. She want to send it for her pastor, whether it's a chicken, a pumpkin, whatever. And what stood out for this woman, and I always say you live on the memory of your mother. What stood out for her, that even though this woman was sick, she was still cooking for her neighbors. She was dishing out food for her neighbors. And I'm saying, Evadne, how can... She said, don't worry about this. God gives strength. She would always say that God gives strength. This woman died in faith, died believing. And you know what she would always tell me? She said, God got my hand. God got my life. It doesn't matter what happens to me. I am in Christ. I was looking to come back to visit her because she was excited about coming out to this program on the 18th. She was telling me, you know, I want to come up to church. I don't know if Pat can pick me up, but I am coming out. That was her seat over there. She used to sit over in this corner. And we will miss Evadne. We will miss her and the love that she poured out, her giving, her heart of giving, her heart of looking out for people. And there are many of us. Ingrid can testify. That was another friend that she would tell me. She and Ingrid prayed on the phone, you know, concerning her health. She was a praying woman. So I say to your to the children and the grandchildren and the family members, live out her memory by being and living the example that she played before you, that she laid out before you, being a giver, a prayer warrior, and a woman that loved the Lord. And the blessed hope is that we will see Evadne again once we live Christ. Once we come into that relationship with God, we will see her again. God bless you. God bless you and keep you. Cause his face to shine upon you always and give you peace. Trust him. In Jesus' name, amen.
We'll be singing, Great is Thy Faithfulness, O God, my Father.
Great is Thy Faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning. Changes not thy compassions, they fail not. As thou hast been, thou forever will be. Great is thy faithfulness. Thy faithfulness.
You ready? Okay, hi. We have come today to lay to rest the body of Virginia Evadne Clarke, body that has toiled through the years, knowing that we here commit to the earth only that which is of the earth. The spirit is in the hands of the same loving God who tenderly cared for her in life and who has provided life everlasting for his own. The Bible promises us that one day death will be no more. How we long for that day. Until then, may we live in anticipation of the time when we too shall lay aside the cares of this life and take up the joys of life eternal. Let us pray. Father, again, we just want to thank you, Father, for the life of Evadne, Lord, a woman, truly a virtuous woman, a woman that used, Lord God, her hands to even toil the earth and to bless. But Father, we know that she is in the presence of the Lord. So Father, we remember the children, her family, the grandchildren, all the family members that surround her. God, I pray that your supernatural strength with be with them at this time. And Father, I pray that the peace of God will garrison around them. Lord, that they will come together even more unified, Lord, as they continue, Lord, to live out their lives even without their mom. Father, I pray that you will be with them in special times, even like this holiday time. Lord, we know it will be difficult, but God, I pray that you will continue to undergird them with your strength. In Jesus' name, amen. For as much as it pleased Almighty God in his wise providence to take out of this world the soul of our sister, we therefore commit her body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, looking for the resurrection at the last day and the life of the world to come through our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose coming to judge the world, the earth and the sea shall give up their dead. The bodies of those who slept in him shall be changed and be made like his glorious body, according to the powers by which he is able to subdue all things unto himself. Badly believe in the power of the blood, and we are going to sing our first song, Power in the Blood.
Would you be free from your burden of sin? There's power in the blood, power in the blood. Would you for evil a victory win? There's wonderful power in the blood. There is power, there is power. wonder-working power
in the blood
of the Lamb.
There is power,
wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. Would you be free from your passion and pride? There's power in the blood. Come for a cleansing to Calvary's tide. There's wonderful power in the blood.
There is power,
wonder-working power
in the blood.
In the blood
of the Lamb.
There is power, wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. Would you be whiter, much whiter than snow? There's power in the blood. Since things are lost in its life-giving flow, there's wonderful power in the blood.
There is power,
wonder-working power
in the blood
of the Lamb. There is power, wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. Would you do service for Jesus, your King? There's power in the blood. Would you live daily His praises to sing? There's wonderful power in the blood.
There is power,
wonder-working power
in the blood of the Lamb.
There is power, wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb.
Amen. Our next song, Marching On.
Let our praises remind all the darkness of how great and how mighty our God is. For the battle belongs to the Lord and no one else.
So you don't have it? Okay. Let's sing together. Marching on in the light of God. Marching on, I am marching on. Up the path that the Master's wrought. Marching, marching on. A robe of white, a crown of gold, a harp, a home, a mansion's fair, a victor's palm, a joy untold are mine when I get there. Marching on through the hosts of sin. Marching on, I am marching on. Victory's mine, well I'm within. Marching, marching on. A robe of white, a crown of gold, a harp, a home, a mansion fair, a victor's psalm, a joy untold are mine when I get there. Marching on while the scepter's near. Marching on, I am marching on. Perfect love casts out all fear. Marching, marching on. A robe of white, a crown of gold, a harp, a home, a mansion's fair, a victor's cell, a joy untold are mine when I get there. Marching on with the flag on flare, marching on, I am marching on. Preaching Christ to a dying world. Marching, marching on. A robe of white, a crown of gold, a harp, a home, a mansion fair, a victor's hall, a joy untold are mine when I get there. Our next song, when we all get to heaven.
Sing the wondrous love of Jesus, sing his mercy and his grace. In the mansions bright and blessed, he'll prepare for us a place. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing out the green. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout a victory. While we walk the pilgrim pathway, clouds will overspread the sky. But when traveling days are over, not a shadow of the sky. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing at the beginning. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout. Just one glimpse of him in glory will the toils of life repay. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. Onward to the prize before us, soon his beauty will behold. Soon the pearly gates will open, we shall tread the streets of gold. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus,
that song, Jireh.
I'll never be more loved than I am right now. Wasn't holding you up, so there's nothing I can do to let you down. It doesn't take a trophy to make you proud. I'll never be more loved than I am right now.
Going through a storm, but I won't go down. I hear your voice carried in the rhythm of the wind to call me out. You would cross an ocean, so I wouldn't drown.
So clear what it's all about.
So stay by my side when the sun goes down. Don't wanna forget how I feel right now.
Yeah, I'm gonna. When she. I'm gonna put it at the end. Oh, this side. Let us pray. Father, again, we want to thank you for the life of Evadne, God. Lord, a blessing to all of us. And Father, as we leave this place, God, Father, I pray that her memory will never die, God, that we will live out, Lord, this woman, the giver she was, Lord, a woman of prayer, a woman that loved God. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus that even as we celebrate you, God, in the next few days, Father, I declare that we would remember, God, that you are the reason. And one thing Evadne would have said is to fear God. So, Father, I declare blessings, the peace of God, cover us and take us home in safety. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you. Your office is already closed.